Hello dear students, welcome to Financial Accounting Classes for Beginners. Today I am going to start new chapter, that is Bank Reconciliation Statement. This is very much important and it is new and required for the new students, especially those who are from non-commerce background. If you are doing CA, CS, BCom, any course without base of intermediate, definitely it is must. And if you are new to this commerce courses, then also it is must. What is this bank reconciliation statement? Before going to that, let me give you a recap of cash book, what we have done in the subsidiary books. In the subsidiary books, we have learned cash book. Cash book means we are writing all the cash transactions on the debit side of cash book. It's like this. Cash book. Debit side, we used to write all the receipts. Credit side, all the payments. Receipts and payment. This you remembered? So, the same thing which is related to the bank. If we are having bank transactions, then bankers are maintaining one passbook. In passbook also, there will be some transactions. The passbook will be like this. Passbook. Passbook, credit side, we write all the deposits. And debit side, we'll write all the payments. So, credit side deposits, debit side all the payments. Now, here receipts and payments. Debit side receipts, here debit side payments. Credit side payments and here deposits, credit side, opposite. Whatever we write it on the debit side, that is to be on the credit side. Suppose say we got some checks. So that we have written on the debit side, we got checks, it's a receipt written on the debit side. Now once if we deposit into the bank, then bankers are collecting these checks. When they collect it, they'll write it on the credit side. Say 500 check I have deposited into the bank. This 500 rupees check, if the bank is going to collect, they will write it on the credit side. Debit, credit, then it is clear. In the same way, credit side, payment. Suppose I am issuing check, I am giving check to someone. Say 1000 rupees check I have given. Means this 1000 rupees check is a payment I am giving to someone. They will go to the bank, they will withdraw from the bank. When they withdraw it, they will write it. The bankers will write it on the debit side. So, this is on the debit side. Credit, debit. Then it's fine. Sometimes debit side we have written, credit side entry is not taken, or credit side is written and debit side is not taken. Any kind of indifferences comes. One side written, one side it is not written. Then there will be indifferences, there will be a difference comes in the cash book to passbook. To find out that difference, we'll be preparing bank reconciliation statement. Are you getting it? Cash book, passbook, both should tally. Tally in the sense debit side, whatever we have, it has to be entered into the credit side of passbook. And cash book, whatever we have written, credit side, that is to tally it with the debit side of passbook. If it is not tallying, then there is a difference. To find out the difference, we are going to prepare bank reconciliation statement. It is required when there is a difference. Both the sides it's written clearly. No need to write bank reconciliation statement. No need to prepare this. It's only where there is a difference between cash book to passbook. Then only we are going to prepare. And here one important thing you have to remember, the balances of cash book and passbook. Remember, cash book always shows debit balance. Debit balance means debit side items are more, credit side items are less. Debit side items are more means receipts are more. Credit side less means payments are more. Receipts are more, payments are less. It means debit balance. Okay? So, cash book, debit, this is a favorable balance, If the cash book is showing like this, then this is a favorable balance. If at all cash book is showing credit balance means credit side is more, payments are more, receipts are less, then it is unfavorable balance. Unfavorable balance when wherever cash book is showing credit. Okay. So if at all cash book is showing credit balance, then it is unfavorable balance, or we can say overdraft. Remember this point, cash book should show always debit, means it is favorable balance, positive. If at all cash book is showing credit balance means payments are more. Payments are more, receipts are less, then it is unfavorable balance. Credit balance means unfavorable, or we'll say overdraft. In the same way, we'll see the passbook also. Passbook should show always credit balance. Credit means deposits are more, payments are less. Then it is a credit balance, favorable balance. Deposits are more, favorable balance. So that is why we'll say passbook should always show credit balance. It means it is favorable balance. If at all passbook is showing debit balance, means payments are more, deposits are less. Payments are more, deposits are less. Then it is unfavorable balance. If passbook is showing debit balance, this is more. So passbook is showing debit balance, then it is unfavorable, or overdraft will say. Remember this, very very important. This you need to remember. Are you getting it? Write down, mind, note down in the mind. Whenever I ask you, even if you are sleeping, if I ask you in the midnight also, cash book which balance shows debit balance, credit balance means overdraft, unfavorable balance. Passbook which balance shows credit balance. Passbook debit balance means unfavorable or overdraft. Like you have to remember. Based on this, we are going to work out the problems. Anyway, now another important thing you must know in BRS is that why the differences comes in the debit side and credit side of passbook and cash book. And why the differences comes on the credit side of cash book and debit side of passbook? Why the differences? Based on differences only we are going to work out bank reconciliation statement. That is why the differences we have to remember. These are the main 8 differences. You find it. If these differences, if you know why the differences comes, which side is more, which side is less, which side is entered, which side is not entered, then automatically you can work out the problem simple. It's a very simple way. Now we'll come to know. Let me clean the board first. So able to remember this? This is very important. First one, we'll see each and every transaction. 8 causes. 8 causes for the difference of passbook and cash book. The first one is check issued but not yet presented for payment. Checks we are issuing. Cash book, passbook. You know debit side, receipts. Credit side, payments. Receipts, I'll write it with blue ink. Receipts, payments. Here, deposits, withdrawals. Now checks issued. Issued means I am giving checks. When issuing checks, when I am issuing the checks in cash book, which side I'll write? Credit side. Issuing payment it is. So here I have to write, suppose it is 1,000 rupees, check issued but not presented for payment. These checks are not presented for payment, not went to the bank. naturally there will be no entry in the passbook. Here no entry. Credit means debit side. If I am issuing check of 1000 rupees, if the person who goes to the bank, who withdraws the amount from the bank, means it would have been written on the debit side of passbook. It's not written, they are saying, not yet presented for payment. Not presented for payment. It means there is no entry in the passbook. But in cash book, I have issued, so I have written. Now, if you see the balance, cash book is credit side, I have written. Which credit side means it is payment. Payment. So it is the cash book balance is decreasing because payment side I have written. Compared to cash book, passbook balance is nothing is there. We have not written anything. But compared to that, passbook is more. More. Because it's increasing. It's decreasing means it is increasing. Like this, this is the first difference. Now we'll see the second difference. Next one, checks paid into bank. Checks we are paying into bank. When we are paying, checks paid means deposited. Checks deposited into the bank but not yet collected by the bank. Checks depositing, when I am depositing checks into the bank, where do I write? Debit side. It's depositing money, I am expecting that amount is going to come. Suppose that this is 2000. 2000 I have written on the debit side. I have deposited. But what happened? Not yet collected by the bank. Bank is not yet collected. Means there is no entry on the credit side. If they have collected, then this would be on the credit side, deposit side, because I have deposited these checks. So this would be collected by the bank, but not yet collected. There is no entry, not yet collected. This is one of the difference. So this comes in the BRS, bank reconciliation statement, where there is a difference between cash book and passbook. That transactions will take it into the BRS, right? So debit side I have written because checks I have deposited. So debit side, receipt side I have written, but now here not yet collected. So this is one of the difference. Now with this difference, what is happening? Cash book balance is here increasing. Debit side I have written, increasing. Now passbook balance is nothing is there. When it is increasing, automatically compared to that, it is decreasing. Compared to that. Are you getting it? So this is about the second transaction. In the same way, third one we'll see. Third one is interest on investments, dividends, etc. Interest on investments, dividends, all these are incomes, na? Etc. Credited in passbook only. Credited in passbook only means directly in the passbook there is an entry. Which side? Credited. Interest on investment, suppose say it is 300, say dividends 200, these are credited deposits are directly taken in passbook only means cash book no entry. Cash book, this is credited in the credited means generally if we know the information we would have written on the debit side, but there is no entry. Only credited in the passbook, there is no entry in the cash book. It is understood whenever they use this word only, it is understood that cash book no entry. Only here we have entry. Which side? Credit side. Means passbook balance is here increasing. Cash book no entry. But compared to passbook, this balance is less. Slowly understand. Are you getting it? Next, we'll see the fourth one. Fourth one is here. Bank charges interest on overdraft, insurance premium, etc. Bank charges interest on overdraft, insurance premium. All these are payments. Payments. Bank is charging. And interest on overdraft. On overdraft also bank is charging interest. Insurance premium, they have to pay insurance premium on behalf of us to the insurance company. This is also payments. Like such kind of payments, debited in passbook only. debited in passbook only. Only in passbook they have debited. Say bank charges say 50 rupees. And interest on overdraft say 100 rupees. And insurance premium they paid on behalf of us 500. These are debited in passbook only. Passbook only it is debited. Means cash book no entry. Passbook only there is an entry. Which side? Debits are payments. Withdrawals, payments, it's gone. So in cash book, there is no entry. If you see this, what happens? Passbook debit side I have written. Debit side means withdrawal side. Withdrawal side means the passbook value is decreasing. Cash book, nothing is there. But if you compare with the passbook, cash book value will be more. Because debited items are not written here, so cash book value is increasing comparing with this. Otherwise, if you see, no balance, it is stable, no change in the cash book. But comparing with this, we can say cash book is increasing because passbook is decreasing. Withdrawal side is written, only in passbook it is written. Are you getting it? Next one, we'll see, fifth one. Fifth one, amount directly deposited by customers into the bank. Amount directly deposited by customers into the bank. Directly, some customers, suppose A, B, C customers are there. They have directly deposited in my bank. When the deposit, it comes on the credit side. Say checks of 2000 and 5000. One is by X, another one is by Y. These two people directly deposited in my bank. Directly deposited means I don't have information. When the deposit directly, I don't have any information. If I have information, I would have written on the debit side. But no information because directly deposited. When the directly deposit, what happens? Passbook values here increasing. Deposit side, it is deposited. Deposit side means it is increasing passbook value. Cash book is no changes, but if you compare with the passbook, cash book value is here decreasing. So arrow marks, simple. So this you remember. Are you getting it? Why it is increasing, how it is decreasing, where we are writing, by writing on so and so side, is it increasing or decreasing? Like you have to identify. Clear? Next one, we'll go for the sixth one. Sixth one, checks issued but not recorded in cash book. I have issued checks. I have issued check. Whenever I am issuing checks, where should I write? Cash book, credit side. Issue na? Payment. Here I have to write. But not recorded in cash book. In cash book, not recorded. Not recorded in cash book. Assumed that these checks are went to the bank and this is withdrawn by the persons to whom you have issued the checks. Say 2000 rupees checks I have issued. They went to the bank, they have withdrawn it. But I forgot to write it into the cash book. This is what saying, na? Checks issued but not recorded into the cash book. Not recorded. There is no entry. But in passbook, assuming that they have collected those checks. So passbook here, credit side, there is an entry. But cash book, nothing is there. Which side? Credit side. Checks issue. Issue means payment. Remember, issue means payment. So this is written on the passbook debit side. It means passbook value is here decreasing. Passbook value is decreasing. Compared to this passbook, cash book value is here increasing. Getting it? So this is about sixth one. Next, seventh one we'll see. Seventh one, checks deposited but not entered into the cash book. Checks we have deposited into the bank. When we deposit the checks, generally we write it on the debit side of cash book, not written on the cash book. When we deposit the checks, so this goes to the passbook. Checks deposited, not entered in the cash book. In cash book there is no entry. When we deposit debit side, we have to write not written. But these checks went to the bank assuming that this is already credited. Say this is 5000 checks. 5,000 rupees checks I have deposited, forgot to write it into the cash book. There is no entry in the cash, but passbook it is entered. Depositing means it is credit side, deposited. 5,000, there is a deposit. So it means passbook value is here increasing. Compared to passbook, cash book value is here decreasing. Are you getting it? So checks deposited but not entered into the cash book. Deposited, we have deposited, means there is an entry into the passbook credit side, not recorded in the cash book. When there is an entry in the deposit side, passbook is increasing. Cash book, there is no entry, but comparing with this, cash book value is decreasing. Next, last one we'll see. Error in cash book or passbook. Error, by mistake something is written. Say for example, 500 rupees, by mistake it is credited into the passbook. Error, by mistake someone's amount is by mistake credited into the bank passbook. Such kind of unexpected credits we don't expect. So there is no entry in the cash book. Unexpected, it's an error, by mistake they have credited in our account. So in such case, passbook value is increasing. Compared to this, cash book value is here decreasing. This is one case. Another case, the bankers are supposed to debit 500 rupees from someone's account, but they have debited in our account 500 rupees to be debited from other's account. By mistake, they have written, say, not 500, say 1500. By mistake, it's debited in our account. Means our passbook value is here decreasing. When they are debiting, when they are withdrawing, its value is decreasing. We can't expect such kind of unexpected errors. So there is no entry in the cash book. There is no entry. So for this reason, passbook value is decreasing. Compared to this, cash book value is increasing. That's all. These are the main differences. You can note down these points. Let me give you a recap of bank reconciliation statement. Simple, easily you can score. If it is 20 marks problem, 20 out of 10, 10 marks problem, 10 out of 10, easily you can score. Don't leave this problem when it comes in the final exam. Definitely, if it is in your syllabus, one problem you can expect. Now, recap, bank reconciliation statement, be prepared where there is a difference in the cash book and passbook. Cash book is more, passbook is less. Or passbook is less, cash book is more. Anytime when there is an imbalance in the cash book and passbook, then we are going to prepare bank reconciliation statement. Now, another important thing you have to remember is here, balances of cash book and passbook. Cash book always shows debit balance. It means it's a favorable balance. Cash book, debit balance, favorable balance. If the cash book is showing credit balance, it is unfavorable or overdraft balance. Next, third one, passbook is always showing credit balance, means deposits are more, then it is a favorable balance. If passbook is showing debit balance, means withdrawals are more, then it is a unfavorable or overdraft balance. Number 2 point you remember this. And number 3, you have to remember why the differences comes in the cash book and passbook. So is this, what kind of differences comes? Why do we get this kind of differences? Now, according to that, if you understand this concept, preparation of BRS is quite easy. In the next problem, next class, we'll take one problem. I'll explain you by taking such kind of transactions. Based on this only, you're going to get all kind of transactions. All kind of problems are based on this. So understand today's class perfectly. Watch it twice or thrice. Slowly watch it, understand it, then we can work out the problems. Please go to the description box or playlist and you can find lot more videos, lot more subjects. And improve your skills, help someone who is struggling to learn the subject. So thank you everyone for your feedback. And I'm finding a very nice comments like you are clearing your subjects, you are getting good marks, you are scoring 10 out of 10, 100 out of 100. That's very nice. Keep it up, my dear students. Wish you good luck.